Teaching definitely gets me up and going in the morning. I have a spring in my step. Essentially, you'll have a lot of challenges that you'll see with students. You'll see problems in class, and you'll see a lot of furrowed eyebrows out there and misunderstanding. But when you see that moment where they get it, it's incredibly satisfying. I joined UBC's Okanagan campus in 2006, shortly after it was created in 2005. And at that time, everything was just getting started. I stepped into course development, developing labs, etc., for the electrical engineering program. We had a lot of industry input, in fact, industry push to create this School of Engineering at UBC's Okanagan campus. And I wanted to try to create the bridges between those industry leaders and ourselves. So I played a role in creating what's called the IEEE student branch. The IEEE is the Institute for Electronic and Electrical Engineers. And that's been a wonderful opportunity for students to go to seminars and field trips and see their engineering colleagues in industry work on different projects. Engineering students in particular are notorious for wanting to know why they're learning something. How does this get used? And as soon as I can drop a reference to a company that's worked with me on a topic, I can talk about various trends in these industries, and I can link that to the classroom topic. You'll notice all of the eyeballs in the class are pointed right at you. Students love to see the relevance of their skills in the world around them. My time is more or less split evenly between research and teaching, although I have to admit, I do blur the line between those quite a bit. In fact, you might even call that my philosophy. I try to have students sometimes forget that they're in a classroom or in a lab. In my mind, it's all about education, and it's not so much about which room you're in.
His teaching evaluation score, which students evaluate you basically at the end of the year, is always one of the highest in our school. Very calm. He's very meticulous. He's been one of the most important people in our school to promote electrical engineering.
Keeping current is why I think my strategy of linking research and teaching together is so effective. We have research going on where we're actually pushing the forefront of technology. We're publishing papers or putting out patents, and so we're really pushing the envelope of modern technology. But I also see our role in a university as taking the students along with that process.
He's got a very good teaching methodology. He goes very slowly and methodically through all the steps, making sure the students understand every step along the way. And he has a really good way of looking into complex problems, tackling it one small bit at a time.
Much of my research work happens within what I call the Integrated Optics Laboratory. And the integrated there is a bit of a play on words. Integrated refers to integrated chips, so we do work with integrated photonic chips, but that integrated also means integrated research and teaching.
He kind of blurs the line between the classroom and the lab, so everything's really applied, and also you kind of have like an internship while you work in the classroom, you're also in the lab doing the experiments and really using the things that he's teaching you at the same time.
The word engagement is the perfect word to use for success in the classroom. So this could be engagement between me and the students, and it could be me using demonstrations or examples, but it could also be between students when they see the success of their peer up in front of them and the fact that their peer can understand these very complicated topics. They get a lot of confidence from that, and I think it's worth its weight in gold, and it's an important part of education.